road that they had been following. The point to the right was paved in gold. So we took that fork to the right and followed it for many more miles.
I need to talk to you for just a second.
Finally, it came to this big golden gate. A big white fence that kept everything out. And at the gate was a man wearing a white robe. He walked up to that man and he asked, "Excuse me, sir, but me and my friend, we've been walking for many miles. I was wondering if we could have some water." The man in the white robe looked at him and then down at his four-legged friend. He said, "Oh, sure. I'll have my servants bring me some at once. But I'm sorry, there's no dogs allowed here." So the man looked down at his four-legged friend and back at the man in the white robe, and he asked, "What do you call this place?" The man in the white robe answered, "This is heaven." The man in the white robe looked down at his four-legged friend, back at that man. The man looked back at him and he said, "Well, thank you, but I think we're just going to keep walking." So the man turned around and walked back to that fork in the road. Finally, he came to that fork and he followed that road to the left, the dirt road that he'd been following originally. So he followed that road for many more miles to come. Finally, he came to this big, wide orchard. The smell of spring flowers filled the air. Butterflies were dancing. Birds were singing. He walked until he came across this man sitting under a tree. He was reading a book. He asked that man with the book, "Excuse me, sir. Me and my friend here, we've been walking for many miles. I was wondering if we could have some water." The man with the book put his book down and smiled. "Oh, sure. Over by that tree over there, you'll see a water pump. And there should be a bowl over there for your friend, too." So the man walked over to that tree. Sure enough, there was a water pump. So he drank until he was full. And he filled the bowl for his brother and friend as well. He felt very peaceful, very connected, like he belonged. So he walked back to that man reading the book under the tree, and he asked, "Excuse me, sir, what do you call this place?" The man with the book answered, "This is heaven." The man looked confused and he said, "But the man down the road, he said that that was heaven." The man with the book laughed. "Oh, you probably mean that place with the big golden road and the golden gate? Nah, that's hell." But the man asked, "But doesn't it anger you that they use your name that way?" The man with the book answered, "Oh no, we're glad that they're there. They filter out all those people who would leave their best friends behind.